Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's going to shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't going to be me, it's going to be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Thank you. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California? Leave all this behind? And just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go. And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre. When I saw it was a time for change. Killed the czar and his minister.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Fuck.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
Sal and Georgie are gone. And after all the shit we've been through, we run this city.
So we finally gonna get our chance to make things right in this town. Bring a balance to things. Wasn't certain we'd ever actually get here.
After all the bullshit, it's almost impossible for me to wrap my brain around the fact that we actually did it. You're a fucking saint, Lincoln. And I'm honored to know you.
No, that's the kind of news you never get tired of hearing.
We're not here because of what I did, or because of what any of y'all did. We're here because we stood together. And as long as we stay strong, ain't no one ever gonna fuck with us.
After he killed Selmer, Connell Lincoln Clay took over. But he wasn't content just to run the city. He expanded out across the South into Florida and even the Carolinas. So much money coming in, and he's been smart with it. He spreads it around, makes sure the right people get paid and stay paid. The city's favorite son. Yeah. Rebuilding the Hollow, buying up Frisco Field, reopening the theme park, all that money and goodwill. He thinks it's made him untouchable, but no one is untouchable. He might have plastered his name across a few schools and hospitals, made donations to a charity here and there, but nothing absolves him of his crimes. That's why I agreed to do this documentary. I want to shine a light on the real Lincoln Clay.
Lincoln gave in to everything. Drugs, booze, prostitutes, you name it. He made a dollar. He was involved. Seeing him on the news, strutting around. Sometimes I think he should have died over at Sammy's with all the rest of them. There'd be kind of a peace in that.
About any of this.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Get out and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered, well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right, no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
God. Don't fucking move! You're out of your mind.
Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you'll
them
never
to
get
see
away
that, you stupid asshole, because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. Oh. And they're next. Gentlemen,
God, you're hurt.